this is Nayalla. Thank you so much for joining me again today. So today, for this Earth Talks, I want to discuss a few things. Well, three main things, really, and they do sort of all go into one another. First off, I want to talk a little bit more about the holographic matrix Earth, really going deeper into it and explaining more about the holographic viewpoint that we get when we do look into the matrix, and how we can sort of start understanding about looking into dimensions a lot more as well. So me and my daughter, a few weeks ago, we were at a local art gallery, and one particular piece that really stood out that is going to highlight how this holographic matrix Earth works was a particular picture that was done as a hologram. And what I'm going to do is try and explain it to you in terms of how the matrix works. So this picture, it was based on a computer game. So we had a boy sat at a computer, and then as you sort of walked past the hologram, obviously, you know, you saw him morphing into other things. So what I was thinking of doing was like speaking about somebody actually coming into the boy's bedroom and what they would see from each point, from each holographic viewpoint. So if we think about him just first off at the computer as an everyday boy, just working away at his computer, his mum would be at the door, and she would just see, as in 3D terms, you know, she would just see her son at the computer, and that's as far as it would go. But then if you think about that same boy, if he was perhaps just doing his schoolwork, you know, when his mum was there, but then he'd finished his schoolwork and he went on to maybe play a particular game, and he joined up with a particular friend, a school friend, and in that game he was a character, and his other friend was a character as well. So then if we get that friend coming to the door, we will see from his friend's viewpoint, we're going to see two separate things. We will see the boy, the schoolboy, on the computer. His friend will see that, but his friend will then also see him as the computer character as well, as whatever he chose to be in that computer game. We'll see him as the character. So his friend will actually see him in two different aspects, as two different characters. And then if we take it a little bit further and bring in a third friend, so walking a little bit further across and seeing that same boy morph again into something different again, let's say he was into another game, and this was a separate friend was joining him for that game, so he was a completely different character again in that game, completely different avatar, so to speak, then that third friend will either see him just as that person from that game, or if he knows him from school and also knows him from the first game, he will then see three different aspects of that same person. So then it's layers. It's like this one person, this one schoolboy, has then got different layers, different dimensions. It's one person, but there's different aspects to it. And that's really how the matrix works. There is different layers to what we are living in. Obviously, the matrix is just one part of it. It is the 3D aspect of Earth. But when we move up in consciousness, when we raise our awareness, when we become a lot more aware of what's happening, we will see things in other dimensions. We will see Earth in different dimensions. We will see other people in different dimensions. And that's why you will hear of people being able to look at one person and straight away see that who they were in a past life, or you know, see them as a different being, see them as a different character, so to speak, is because that veil is thin, or the veil is non-existent, and they're looking into something that from a 3D viewpoint you just wouldn't see at all. You would just see the schoolboy. You wouldn't see what else was happening. You wouldn't see him as another two or three different characters, if that makes sense. So that's really how it works, is you, if you're just thinking in 3D terms, you're just gonna see 3D living. But if you become higher in consciousness, then everything starts opening up and expanding, and your viewpoint just grows and grows, and you start seeing much, much, much more about yourself and about the world you live as well. And you'll see that there's secondary and third meanings to so many other things as well. So secondly, what I want to speak about is the whales, because they are making a huge wave, so to speak, right now this year. The whale energy is coming in very, very strongly. And I did actually get a little message about the whales coming through as well. So the whale consciousness is coming forward in a strong way right now, because they actually want to work with us and team up with Earth as well, which they are already doing. But they want us humans, human consciousness, to really work with them energetically. So if you are somebody who is a natural energy healer or energy worker, or somebody who can actually move and manipulate energy, then you might want to have a little bit of a play around with this and really tune in with that whale energy. Because what that message came forward for me to say was that we have got a lot of healing through water going on right now. We've got a lot happening with our seas, with our oceans, and yeah, a lot of it is very heavily polluted, and we've got a lot of that darker, heavier energy going on. But what the whales would like to do is really help the Earth, as the Earth is bringing up this denser energy to be cleared. The Earth, what has been happening is the Earth has been sucking it out of herself. So that's why we've got a lot of this corruption coming to the surface right now, is Earth is actually sucking it out and bringing it to the surface, because she's healing, she's clearing. And what the whales would like us to do is really help to take that energy, to lighten the load of Earth, of Gaia, and bring it to the sea so that it can be transmuted. What the whales are also wanting to do is really help us to tune into group consciousness or unity consciousness. And as we do that, we will not only be, you know, as humans, bringing forward that unity consciousness and joining together as a unit for the humans, but also understanding that we work as a team. Anything that is living on this earth right now is all joined together. We've all got this network. It might be unseen, it might be unfelt to many, but there is this network, this thread going on, really connecting all of us together. And that is really the message from the whales. They really want us all to come together and work together to clear this, what I call false darkness, and even false light as well, to clear that, to allow it to come to the surface, to clear it and transmute it, so that we've got much purer energy staying with us, so we can work with much purer energy moving forward. So really working as one with Gaia, with Earth energy, so that we can all clear that yuckiness together, really. So that's why many of us have really been guided, if not pushed, by the divine to really do that inner work, because this is a lot bigger than us on an individual level. We're actually doing it collectively, and we're actually working with other creatures on this earth as well, all trying to support and help one another as well. So it really expands unity consciousness to a whole new level. And also, I want to go into a little bit about climate change as well. One of the channelings from Earth did speak about climate change. Didn't really go a lot into it. I am due to do another channeling session, so I'm going to speak, I'm going to ask a bit more about climate change and hopefully get a bit more about that. But what did come forward is that climate change isn't what we've been led to believe. It is very different, and we've got a lot of this fear-mongering, guilt and shame energy really connected to climate change. What Earth was very much making it very clear is that there is a natural cycle taking place right now. Earth is in the process of a natural cycle, and that's got absolutely nothing to do with the humans. We haven't created it. It's something that does happen naturally. It's what Earth does naturally. She goes through cycles, and she is in the process of going through one of her natural cycles. Yes, our disrespect, yes, our ignorance and our blindness has caused issues. It is causing issues, but there is a lot of manipulation going on, and there is a false narrative to climate change as well. So it is very important that we all do our part to clean up, but we also let go, sort of dissociate climate change with feeling guilty or feeling that we are to blame, because there is a certain group that are manipulating. There is a certain group that are trying to force a false narrative onto the collective as well. So be very mindful of where your energy is going, and also really tune into how something makes you feel as well. Because if it has got a guilt, shame undertone to it, then very likely it is a false narrative. So really stay very aware, stay very alert to what you are tapping into at this time. This, for all of us, this time is really about embracing transitions as a natural part of life. We are all going through this transition. We are all going through this sort of death and rebirth on a spiritual level, but there's also a lot of that going on physically right now as well. Many of us are experiencing, like we said, cycles coming to an end, but also transitioning of pets, loved ones, and, you know, maybe parts of ourselves as well that are dying to really bring forward a new, fresher energy. And that's what Gaia, that's what Earth's doing right now as well. So transitions are a natural part of life, and they're essential. It's an essential part of evolution and life in general. I mean, we've got seasons going on. We've got natural flow going on with the seasons and with our bodies. And, you know, it, like we said, it's part of life. So it's important, again, that we really change our views on transition, on all transition, and life and death is very much transition as well. We are, all of us, being asked of a very big thing here, and that is to almost just sort of take what we've known and rip it up and throw it away and start again. And that is scary. It is a scary thing to start from scratch, especially if you're of a certain age and all you've known is one thing, and then all of a sudden, like the blinds being taken away from your eyes, and you're seeing life in a completely different way. It is scary. It is a big deal, but this is part of it. This is part of this awakening process, and we are all being asked to do it to varying degrees. You know, nobody is not at some degree being affected by what's going on. And I know many people, they speak of maybe non-player people or non-souls or the unawakened, but even those people to some degree will be affected by what's going on. It's up to them if they choose to go with it or if they choose to resist. You know, we're all here living our own life, you know, going our own way, but it's our choice if we choose to fully embrace the awakening or if we say not for me. And you can't force somebody to awaken. You can't force somebody to change how they see things. You can't change their viewpoint for them. It has to be done on an individual level. So that's really all that I want to share today for this Earth Talks, is to really understand about how this holographic viewpoint works, because in a sense it is to do with climate change as well, and it is to do with the awakening. Because if you are only looking at the picture from a certain angle and haven't actually gone further into that holographic viewpoint, you're not going to be able to see what somebody else can who's further into it and can see a bit more than you. So that's why it's silly trying to argue with somebody that can't see what you can see. I mean, you can tell them what you know, you can guide them in a certain direction, but until they actually get to that place and can see what you're seeing, or have more of an understanding or a knowing of what you can see, you're just basically wasting energy. So I'm going to leave that with you today. I hope that has helped you in some way. I'm sending you so much love, and I hope to see you again very, very soon. Goodbye for now.